Hello students, I'm your English teacher and today I will continue our last week topic letter writing. Last week we have discussed about informal letter which is also called personal letter and this week we will discuss about formal letter. So formal opinion letter and formal request letter are good example of formal letter. As compared to personal letter, formal letter is different. Because in formal letter, audience will be different and the purpose of writing formal letter also different. So mainly we use formal letter for official work where we are going to request or share our opinion with the people in authority. A good example, suppose if you are writing a letter to a school principal, it will comes under formal letter. And if you are writing a letter to a friend, it will come in personal letter. So let's compare personal letter and formal opinion letter to understand better. So the audience of personal letter is your friends and family member. But in formal opinion letter, the audience will be people in authority, right? The people in authority will be the audience where you are going to request them to make some changes or to take action. Okay, let's understand with the example. Suppose your street lights in your area are not working properly, so you can write a letter to municipal corporation and you can request them or you can share your opinion. So then people in authority, who? Municipal corporation, will take action or make some changes, right? So that's formal opinion letter. As compared to personal letter, here we have to use little bit serious yet polite language. But in case of personal letter, you can use friendly language. Here, in greetings, you have to add dear sir, dear madam. Where you in previously in personal letter, you are using the persons, the next persons, your friend, your family member, first name only. But here you have to start with dear sir or dear madam. Right, so these are mainly some comparison points of personal letter and formal opinion letter. Okay, other examples can be of formal letter is writing a letter to a teacher, writing a letter to bank manager, writing a letter to chairman, writing a letter to electricity board, or any changes you want, right? So if you want to request someone, then we will write formal letters. Okay, let's understand formal opinion letter body part. Okay, so now if you want to make some changes, so that means you have to convince them, you have to give them solid reasons, right? So what reasons, supporting reasons you can give to them is, I have given one example here. For example, write 3 reasons why junk food should not be given in school. Junk food, you know na? What is junk food? The pizza, burger, sandwich, oily food is a junk food, right? So reasons are, junk food has bad fat. It will make you unhealthy. It will make you fat. Second, it has more sugar and salt as compared to our everyday or regular diet. Okay, like soda, Coca-Cola, Pepsi and fast food. Okay, one more reason you can give is that junk food does not have important vitamins and minerals as compared to fruits and vegetables, right? These reasons you can give to take them action. Now let's understand, I have given few more examples to understand better the purpose and audience of a letter. Our first example, dear Samantha, how are you? It's been a long time since I wrote to you. I recently went to Mysore for the Dasara celebration and wanted to tell you all about it. Here you are writing a letter to your friend. Who is the audience? Your friend. Your friend name is Samantha. Okay, and you are describe the experience of Dasara celebration. Okay, is it clear? So this is a informal letter, personal letter. Second one, dear sir, I am writing because I think school bus should pick up and drop students from outside of their houses instead of end of the street. This is a formal opinion letter. Why? Because the audience is different. This time audience is not friend or family. The audience is school principal, or it can be teacher or transport supervisor in school. Let's see one more example. Dear madam, I am writing to ask for the details about paying the school fees. When is the last date for it? What is the late fee? Right? So this is also a formal letter, but a formal request letter. You can write this to a class teacher or a bank manager. Okay? So I hope you understood. Always see what is the main difference in a formal letter and a personal letter is the audience and purpose will decide the type of letter. Who will decide? The audience and purpose. So if audience is friends and family, simple, personal letter. If audience is people in authority, then formal letter. Let's see the parts of formal letter. First, we will write from address, to address, date, salutation, introduction, main reason, and supporting reasons, conclusion. So interesting thing is here, salutation is nothing but a body part of formal letter where you will write introduction or main reason, then you will write supporting reason and conclusion. That is the part. This is called salutation. Then you will at the end, closing, signature of the person who is sending the letter and name of the person who is writing the letter. Is it clear? I repeat one more time. At the beginning, we will write from address. I hope you remember, in case of personal letter, we were writing only one address. Here we are writing both address. From address also we are writing, and to address also we are writing, right? So keep in your mind. Then comes to date. So while writing date in any letter, you must write the day, then month in English. Don't write 6 or 7. If you want to write June or July, write June, J-U-N, J-U-L-I. Don't write 6 or 7. It is a wrong manner. Okay? So then you will write 15 June or July 2020. When it comes to the salutation, that is a body part where you are going to give the reasons. You are going to give the reasons to support your main argument or your main reason, right? Why you are writing a formal letter? Why you are writing formal opinion letter? What is your purpose, right? That purpose you have to describe in a body part or salutation part. And at the end comes conclusion. And conclusion will always relate the introduction. Is it clear? Let's see one example. So I have mention one example here for you to understand better what is formal opinion and formal request letter. I have written first from address, where I have written Priya Das, number 45, 6th Main Road, 6th Cross, Shri Ram Nagar, Bangalore, 540084 is pin code. After from address, I have mentioned to address. To Manjunath Kaman, Maintenance Supervisor, Green Park, Bangalore, 560098 pin code. Then I have mentioned the date. So in from address, first we will always we will write first our from address. Keep in your mind, first from address, then afterwards we will write to address. Okay, is it clear? And see, both in both addresses the common is Bangalore is a common city, but the area is a different. Right, because that is a problem where you are writing a letter to the people in authority and they will solve your problem. They will take action. Date I have written 15 July 2020. Then I have written greetings. Dear sir. Whenever it is dear sir or madam, you keep in your mind, it will be always a formal letter. Always a formal letter. Then I have written introduction or main reason. I am writing because I think that children should not be allowed to play in park till the swings and slide are repaired. So here situation is, our main reason of writing is swings and slides are not in good condition. So I am writing this letter to Manjunath Kaman, who is the supervisor of Green Park, right? Okay. After introduction and main reason, we have to write the supporting reasons. we have to describe the situation, what is going on there, right? We have to describe that. The swings and slide are sharp edges which makes scratch children and hurt them. The loose end of the streams may give way and fall when children swing them. Also, since the park authority have not put a warning sign, many parents don't know about it. These are all supporting reasons I have given here in this formal request letter, okay, which will relate directly to the main reason. The main reason is the swings and slides are not in good condition. So here the park have not given any warning sign, not mention any special note. So these are all supporting reasons I have given here in this letter. What comes after supporting reasons? Conclusion. Okay, it will relate to the introduction. So in conclusion I have written, can I request you? See, whenever you are writing conclusion, you have to request to the person in authority where you are going to request them, then they will take the action. So can I request you to please make sure that children are not allowed into the park or play area till the slide and swings are repaired. Okay, this is the conclusion of the letter, and at the last I have written yours sincerely as a closing, then the signature of the sender and name in the block letter. So you understand one thing, that signature is different and name is different, right? So many people have their signature as same as name only, but most of the cases their signature is different and name is different. Okay, so I hope you keep all these points in your mind. So these are the steps or parts of writing formal letter. One more example we can see here. I have written one more letter where I have start from address. So who is writing this letter? Shantanu Bhattacharya. Where he is living? He is living at number 12 First Main 6 Cross Rane Benno 58115. And he is writing a letter to whom? To the school principal, Kannur Vidyaniketan School, Rane Benno 58115. So instead of Shantanu Bhattacharya, you can write your own name. You can write Spandana, you can write Sanika, you can write Pritam, whatever your name, right? Then in two address, I have mentioned the city and with pin code. Then after two address comes the date. I have written 9 July 2020. Keep in your mind, student, always write date in a proper manner. Then comes the greeting, dear sir. It shows it is a formal letter. Then start from introduction. I am writing to you because I think that children should not be served junk food during the meal time in school. This is the main reason, introduction of your letter. After main reason comes the supporting reasons. So dear student, when I will give you homework, must you write the letter and label all the parts. Label it, okay, so I can understand, okay, the student have understand the topic or the concept of formal letter. Then what I have written here in supporting reason, junk food has bad fat in it and can make the student unhealthy. Also, it has higher amount of sugar and salt, which are harmful for everyday diet or everyday eating. Food items like burger and soft drinks after insert, and this can make children ill if eaten every day. Finally, these food items do not having the important vitamins and minerals that are present in fruit and vegetables. I would now, after these supporting reasons, I have written the conclusion. I would like to request you to please make sure that the canteen does not serve unhealthy food like this in our Kannur Vidyaniketan school. And at the last, the closing and signature and name. Thank you. Your sincerely. See, in case of closing, in personal letter, we were writing? We are writing your lovable, your loving, or your friend, right? But in case of formal letters, we always write your obedient or your sincerely or your faithfully, right? These are all different closing for formal letter. And I have did the signature of Shantanu Bhattacharya, and then comes the Shantanu Bhattacharya name. Okay, so these are two examples I have used here to explain the formal letters. I hope, student, you have understood the concept and the topic of formal letters. And in case of homework, there is no special homework or no special worksheet. So this much only, these two letters which I have given here, you have to copy. You have to write one more time in your notebook or homework book. That